your body. And you know it was nobody but God. Nobody but God. Amen. In this situation, the Levite knew their situation. But in our situations in the congregation, most of the time the preacher does not know your situation. And if your situation is touched upon, then it's the Lord giving you a solution to your problem, comforting you and assuring you that, yay, I will be with you even to the end of the world. I will not leave you. I will not forsake you. And the way looks bleak and it looks hopeless, but I'm there for you. So don't fear and don't be dismayed, because we serve an awesome God. Amen.
Amen.
And even when the prophet proclaims the message, we ought to praise God. We ought to praise God for it. Amen.
The third point I want to make this morning is that when we seem to be in impossible situations, we have to be armed with the shield of faith and with praise on our lips. Jehoshaphat told the people in verse 20, "Believe in the Lord your God, so shall you be established. Believe his prophets, so shall you prosper." And what Jehoshaphat was saying is, you just got to have faith. You got to have faith that what God said he will do, he will do. You got to have faith that even though you don't know what's going to happen, because God has not declared what's going to happen, but because your God is awesome, because
Jesus has already won the battle for you.
Amen.
And so Jehoshaphat told the people, just praise. Amen. Just praise. And so in the midst of your impossible situation, you ought to be in your kitchen just praising the Lord. You ought to be in your car just praising the Lord for his awesome power. You ought to be in the tub just praising the Lord. You ought to be in the grocery store walking down the street just praising the Lord. Striking fear in the heart of the enemy who's trying to attack you. Maybe trying to attack your prosperity, trying to attack your health, trying to attack your mind, trying to attack your family. You ought to praise the Lord and lift up the truth about Almighty God in the midst of the situation. Remind the enemy that your God is awesome. Your God is awesome. Amen. Amen. And then finally, when you're in a seemingly impossible situation, we need to praise our awesome God for giving us the victory. Because we know that by and by, God's going to have the victory. Amen. There's no case too hard for God. There's no battle that God cannot win. In verse 22, it said, when they began to sing and to praise, the Lord set up an ambush against the children of Ammon and Moab and Mount Seir, which were come against Judah, and they were smitten. The Bible tells us that God set up an ambush, and they got so confused they began to kill each other. They destroyed each other because of the awesome God and Jehoshaphat and his army were just out there on the battlefield just praising the Lord. The Bible says it took 3 days for Israel to gather up the spoils and the treasures after they were all dead. And on the fourth day, they gathered themselves together to return to Jerusalem. And when they returned, every man of Judah in Jerusalem and Jehoshaphat, leading them in the front, went to Jerusalem with joy, praising the Lord. The Bible says, for the Lord had made them to rejoice over their enemies. And they came to Jerusalem with string instruments and harps and trumpets unto the house of the Lord to praise his holy name for the victory that he had given them. When God gives us a victory, when the awesome God moves in your experience, you need to take time to praise his holy name. Lift him up on high to fortify your faith and to let somebody else know that God is an awesome God. You serve a mighty God, and what God will do for them, just like he's done it for you. Only the awesome God can give us victory over impossible situations. And I know he's awesome. I know he's awesome because only our awesome God can create the universe in 6 days. I know he's awesome because only an awesome God could part the Red Sea so that the children of Israel could walk over on dry. Awesome. I know he's awesome because only an awesome God could cook. He will rescue me, and he will rescue you, because you're children of God, and he loves you. If indeed the awesome God has done something for you that's